The next hidden barrier to finding your passion and living your dream is that most of your self-image is actually hidden from you. The level of detail in your self-images is astonishing. You have literally thousands of beliefs about different elements of yourself, including every dimension or trait you can possibly imagine. Some of them you're aware of. If I said, describe yourself to me, you'd say, well, I'm either shy or outgoing. I'm laid back or intense. I'm intelligent or street smart. I'm creative or organized. And these types of beliefs about yourself, they're obvious to you. You know about them and can pretty much guess how they affect your directions and choices on a daily basis. Consider yourself outgoing and charming, then you'll probably network at parties. See yourself as a natural salesperson, you'll start a business. Think you're good with numbers, you'll pull out the spreadsheet and calculate your mortgage. If I gave you an hour and a pen and a piece of paper, you could come up with a pretty bang-on description of your personal qualities and traits. And you could very easily connect them with your life choices and your actions. Your life choices make sense to you, even if you don't like them. You're congruent. But there's an even deeper level of your self-image than this, because up until now, you've never considered just how detailed this self-image really is. Let's take Martha, for example. She's got a pretty good self-image in relationships, but her self-image about getting dates, not so good. See, Martha was married for 20-something years, and she hasn't tried to get a date in a very long time. When I asked Martha, I said, describe yourself in flirting and attracting men, and she sort of started to squirm. In Martha's mind, she's an awkward 16-year-old, not a sexy, attractive lady with decades of relationship experience. Now, do you think that Martha goes out and tries to meet men on a regular basis? I'm thinking, never. But before I asked Martha about her ability to flirt and attract men, she had no awareness of this element of her self-image. When I was competing as an elite athlete, I happened to create a belief for myself that I was great under pressure at the World Championships, but only just a little bit above average at the National Championships. And this probably started out as a superstition, but I parlayed it into an actual belief, and it became a self-fulfilling prophecy for me, much to my confusion at the time. Some people are fine when speaking to a group of 30 people, but put them in front of a room of 100 people and they fall apart. Some people can easily make money selling other people's products, but when they try to sell their own, the flow of wealth to them is mysteriously blocked. Some people can present a proposal with confidence to their peers, but ask them to pitch senior management and they suddenly get tongue-tied. Some people ooze charm and charisma one-on-one, but put them in a small dinner group and they clam up. So let me repeat, there are literally thousands of images, beliefs, and attitudes about yourself in your mind that you may never have even glimpsed before. Now, another reason we don't see certain elements of our self-image is that we're blind to them. We don't know what we don't know. Let's imagine you want to start a business. Well, there are six key skills you need to win in business. The first is the ability to provide appealing products and services. Number two, you need to affordably acquire customers. Number three, you need to be able to manage that business for a maximum profit. Number four, you need to be able to retain customers, maximize their value. Number five, you need to be able to develop equity in the business. And number six, you need the skill of being able to meet your personal lifestyle and goals. And on some level, you're dimly aware of all of these skills and you have a self-image in your mind about where you stand in each of them, no matter how limited your experience in business really is. And the stronger your collective I'm a business person self-image is, the more likely you'll take action in starting that business. Now let's go deeper still. What about the self-limiting beliefs that are completely hidden from your conscious awareness and only make themselves known through your behavior? These are the really tricky ones. Let's imagine that you're the kind of person who procrastinates a lot. You know, you don't study until the night before. You're late getting things done. You watch TV instead of doing what you're supposed to do, even if it's a personal goal that you've set for yourself. In 8 out of 10 cases, this behavior stems from the fact that you are harboring an unconscious belief that you will not be able to please people. Deep down, you feel incapable of fulfilling your expectations. You just don't think it's possible. You don't see the point. And you might be a smart, competent, and talented person and know intellectually in your mind that this belief is flat out wrong, yet somewhere deep inside you this belief is there and it might be sabotaging you. Now where would a belief like this come from? Well, in most cases, it comes from times in your childhood when you tried to please a caregiver or a parent but never felt like it was really possible. You couldn't really get there. You know, maybe the parent didn't celebrate your achievements with enough praise. Maybe the parent was a bit critical. Maybe the parent's expectations were just out of whack given your personality, your interests, and your context at the time. In these situations, what most people do when they're really little is they withdraw to protect themselves from the pain of not being able to satisfy these expectations. And they conclude, they develop an unconscious conclusion or belief that they will never be able to satisfy this parent, and they take the stance of, what's the point in giving my all? Now, with this belief, you have programmed yourself to be a little bit passive, or at least inconsistent, when it comes to either pursuing that dream, finding the passion, or performing. You are on strike and you didn't even know it. All you know is that you chop and change in life and stop and start. You're a little bit flaky, or you stop yourself a few steps from success and it's baffling to you because you never glimpsed, you never saw that hidden part of your self-image that believes you might never be enough. Here's another one. Let's imagine that you keep finding yourself in relationships with people who take you for granted, underappreciate you, or worse, are actually abusive to you. They withhold affection and are stoic when it comes to showing you love. But the guys and gals who worship the ground you walk on, they're boring to you. They aren't a challenge, and you dismiss them on the grounds that there is no spark. Well, in 8 out of 10 cases, being wildly attracted to the wrong people comes from the fact that you have an unconscious belief that you are not completely lovable or worthy of love. Now, you know intellectually this is complete hogwash, but you can't shake the feeling of unlovability inside. Now, where does a belief like this come from? In most cases, it comes from the fact that when you were young, a caregiver sometimes treated you with indifference or scorn or hostility or even hatred. So you conclude that you're not worthy of love, and you spend your life trying to get it from people who withhold it from you, because that's what's congruent with this underlying self-image. Now, you can see that we are actually unaware of major building blocks of our self-image at any given time. And that's why unlocking the key to your potential will mean pulling back the curtain and seeing the entire blueprint that you're holding about yourself. But for today, though, I want you to go down below and blog your very best story, a confession, thoughts or comments on your own personal thoughts on self-image or your own personal adventures in beliefs that are maybe hidden from you. And also, please make sure you sign up. You'll want to get in on that free webinar where I'll be releasing all kinds of secret content from my Live Your Dreams program, which is opening up again to a small class in about 10 days' time. So go ahead, blog me your best story, sign up for the webinar, and I'll talk to you again soon.